Good morning and welcome to the 2021 World Dairy Expo. I'm Peggy Coffeen, editor with Progressive Dairy Magazine, and we are live here this morning in the GEA Farm Technologies booth. We are so excited to be back here together in person, and this morning we will be walking you through on a virtual tour that includes six renowned experts from the GEA field. So, from wherever you're at this morning, grab a cup of coffee, get comfy, and join us for this virtual tour. And we'd love to hear where you're watching from this morning, so go ahead and drop where you are watching from in the chat. And if you have any questions for the experts you'll be hearing from today, drop those questions in the comments below and they will be answered this week during World Dairy Expo and next week. And to kick off our tour this morning, we are here with Matt Roberts. Matt, tell us a little bit about yourself and what you'll be showing us today.
Yeah, good morning. My name is Matt Roberts with GEA Farm Technologies. I'm a regional sales manager for GEA and cover the east region of the U.S.
Excellent. And what's the technology that you'll be revealing for us today?
Yeah, I'm going to be talking about the DairyProQ. The DairyProQ is our rotary robot. Comes in sizes from 28 stalls to 80 stalls and can be operated with one person.
Excellent. And what is it about this that's unique?
Yeah, we're the only complete automated rotary robot on the market. And the nice thing about this product, it works great for retrofits. You're not going to disturb the barn and the cows when you're installing this. And it makes an easy retrofit to eliminate the milkers in your herd.
Thank you, Matt. And one of the biggest questions that dairy farmers are facing as they look towards robotic technology is they're evaluating the option of a robotic rotary versus multiple box robots. Why would a farmer consider one or the other?
Yeah, I think when you're looking at larger herds, once we start putting individual boxes throughout the barn, there's a lot of construction cost that goes along with that, and there's a lot of time of fetching cows, where here we can run this with one cow mover and one operator in the pit.
Thank you. So you're alluding a little bit here towards labor efficiency, right?
For sure.
So what type of labor efficiency or reduction can one expect with an installation of the DairyProQ?
Yeah, you're looking at an 80-stall rotary. It could be operated with one operator.
Excellent. And how many of these parlors has GEA installed?
Yeah, we have eight across the U.S., anywhere from a 40-stall to an 80-stall.
Excellent. Thank you for showing us the DairyProQ, Matt. And now we're going to just spend a little bit of time here talking about the DairyRotor T8800. So tell us about this piece of equipment.
Yeah, this is our T8800 line. We have a T8800 and T8900. The T8800 is more for a commercial 24-hour-a-day operations. That's available from a 32-stall all the way to 120-stall rotary.
And what makes it unique from other rotary parlors?
Well, what's unique about the T8800 is the undercarriage and the drive system underneath. It's on a roller system built for a robust application commercial market to run 24 hours a day.
And what herd size is the most economical for the T8800?
I would say a 24-hour application. Like I said, it's available in a 32-stall all the way to 120-stall. So we gear more towards a commercial market, but it can also be used in a smaller herd size also.
Excellent. Thank you so much for sharing this with us, Matt. And we're going to keep moving on to our next stop this morning. And so if you have any questions on the technologies that you're seeing or for these GEA experts, go ahead and drop those in the chat below and they will be answered this week right here at World Dairy Expo, or they will be answered in the weeks to come. And now we're going to take a visit over here with Andy Lenkaitis.
Good morning.
Andy, tell us about what you do for GEA and what you'll be showing us today.
Yeah, so for GEA, I work as an AMS herd management engineer, so I help farmers as they transition from conventional milking systems to automated milking systems and help them learn how to use the information, manage the data, and run their farm day-to-day with the new installation.
Excellent. And tell us what's new on this latest model of the R9500.
Yes, we made a lot of updates to the R9500. The nice thing about having these systems in now in the U.S. for 4 or 5 plus years and globally even longer than that, gives us a great opportunity to look back at our service records, the durability of the equipment, where can we improve things. And so a lot of changes are very small and minor, but really make a big difference in the day-to-day for the customer and what their overall total cost of ownership can be.
And what makes it different than some of the other box robots on the market?
The big thing with the R9500 is our inliner everything, and that's the unique prep process where that cow walks in the box, that arm comes out, it attaches to her teat, it does stimulation, cleaning, and prep all in the cup together. Once we pass our checks for milk quality, milk quantity, and color, it goes through and transfers from the calf milk side to the good milk side, and we start milking that cow just like it would in a conventional system. So it's really better for the animal that we have blazing fast box times of about 6 minutes, but when that cow walks in to when she's in full milk flow is very comparable to what we see in a conventional milking system of that 45 to 90 seconds from first touch to full milk flow. Then at the end of milking, it actually post-dips right in that cup so that that barrel of the teat is fully covered in post-dip, that arm goes back in, and the cow goes on her way.
Excellent. So great functionality, but let's talk about data. What are some of the ways that data is collected in this system?
Yeah, so that's the unique thing about the robotic system. You know, between the DairyProQ and the R9500s, we get a lot of information back about the individual cow and about that individual milking. So we can take all that data and analyze it in different ways, but it's nice that we can look quarter by quarter on that animal and know exactly what each quarter is doing as far as milk flow, milk weight, conductivity, and even somatic cell count. We have an M6850 sensor that can be added on to the module, and that gives you a quarter cell count so you can look at analyzing each quarter milk, look, decide what you want to do for mastitis treatment to really maintain your milk quality. The biggest thing is that we can look and we can identify cows that have issues. Maybe they're sick, maybe they're starting to get a little stomach upset, and we can identify that because they're not coming to the robot, or they're not having the same milk out that they had previously, or their conductivity is spiked. We have those different bits of information to help dial us into really what's going on with that cow on a day-to-day basis.
So we're talking individual cow management, even individual quarter management.
Exactly.
Excellent. All right. And what type of herd management support does GEA provide on these robots?
So we provide a lot of support to our dealers, and our dealers go and provide support to the customers. So we work alongside of them to go to customers and help them with their day-to-day management. We provide a good startup service that we go out and assist in the startup, get you used to using the data. And the important thing is we come back the next couple weeks or the next month, because startups are crazy. You know, it's everyone's tired. You're trying to get the cows to learn a new routine. So we come back and really teach you how to relearn the system, relearn how to manage your cows on a day-to-day basis. We have a good team built up now. I think there's six of us in herd management, so we have a diverse background, and really gives us a good opportunity to pull within our own team for milk quality or nutrition or farm management. So kind of a good group to pull from and provide service to our dealers and customers.
Excellent. So the all-encompassing factors of the efficiency on the milking side, the data, the precise management, and the support to go along with it.
Yeah, it really is a good package.
Thank you, Andy.
Thanks, Peggy.
We're going to be moving on in the GEA on our virtual booth tour today, visiting our friend Keith over here talking about hygiene. And as you're watching our show today, please feel free to drop into those comments any questions that you have for any of the experts that are here today, as well as any questions or comments about some of the exciting technologies that you're seeing. And now we're over here with Keith. Keith, tell us a little bit about yourself and what you'll be showing us today.
I'm the business development manager for hygiene for GEA in the United States. I grew up on a dairy farm, Lucky Holsteins. Today we have several excellent things to show you. We have our Plus line of teat dips right here with Oxycide Plus, that's a pre-dip from concentrate. We have Teat Coat Plus and iodine, and we have Velocity Plus. All of these have, you can set at different ranges for concentration and emollient. Do what's best for your dairy farm.
Excellent, excellent. And tell us a little bit about some of the automated sprays that you're working with as well.
So, first of all, I'm going to tell you about with the Plus Teat Dips, we have two different blending systems that we can blend them with. We have an IntelliBlend XP that can do a pre or a post on your farm, no need for calibration. We also have a DigiBlend for large farms. Now, once we've made the dip, we have some awesome options for automation for your parlor. First of all, we got the IntelliSpray XP, which we have behind us, which is a walkover sprayer that is a robust and intelligent system. It's robust as far as your cow's going over it, and it's an intelligent as far as having the PLC that we can program it with multi-sensor technology to get the best coverage on your cows. And then we also have for rotaries, the UtterMister 1.0. The UtterMister 1.0 is for rotaries, so you could pre or post right on the rotary with the wand that comes out. Stop by and come see us. We can show you videos of both the IntelliSpray XP and the UtterMister 1.0.
Excellent, Keith. And so what are some of the benefits of incorporating automation into the teat dipping process?
You know, first thing that comes to mind is consistency. You know, our workforce, you know, we've got to find them first and we got to train them and getting consistency in the job done. Second thing is really, where can you save some labor? Where can you save some steps? And if you're not saving labor, it might mean more cows per hour. So it's really about looking for the goals for someone's dairy and matching and lining those up. So we're looking at a lot more semi automatic options along with our fully automatic options.
Excellent. Thank you, Keith. And what would be one or two kind of decision-making factors that a dairy farmer can incorporate into making their choices with the dips and some of the automation things that you've talked about today?
Yeah, so we have a lot of different options because we want to suit things for your dairy farm. And so with teat dips, we've got to line it up with the mastitis organisms that we're dealing with to find the most cost-effective and effective choice for you. We made these teat dips from our premium line in concentrate form to give an opportunity to have versatility on farm with different environmental changes and mastitis changes, and also so that we can hopefully reduce some cost. Now, when you consider the blending, I mean, you need to consider the size of your farm. For the automation with the automatic sprayers, it really comes down to what do you need for consistency and labor. They do use more dip than a traditional hand dipping, but if you can have some big labor savings or getting some consistency, there can be some big benefits to be had.
Thank you so much, Keith, for sharing your knowledge and also these benefits that can really transform the way that cows are milked on our dairies. All right. And we will be moving on our virtual tour of the GEA Farm Technologies booth. And we come over now to Jeremy. Jeremy, we'll have you tell us a little bit about who you are and what you'll be showing us today.
All right. My name's Jeremy Sanford. I'm the Global Product Manager for Manure Equipment for GEA. We're going to talk a little bit about some of our new products, of course, about our scraper systems and a few things going on in the industry.
Excellent. So what's new with GEA Manure Management Technology?
So in the last, 12 months, we've brought out quite a few new products. One of the products is our 10-inch Lagoon Super Pump, kind of making some waves in the industry, if you would. This thing is really showing the performance out in lagoons. We work pretty well to agitate up the lagoons, get that manure in suspension, make sure all the nutrients are well distributed when they get to the field so that they can have proper application. Another thing that we did along with that, we added Hardox, which is a proprietary material that a harder steel in the lagoon housing, as well as the impeller in the bottom as well, just for longevity for guys specifically in sand, but of course anybody who just wants a longer lasting pump. And then that transferred into the rest of our PTO line. So we've got Hardox available in all of our PTO line for any customer that wants to extend that use. Of course, that's not the end. We'll continue to advance as far as further abrasive resistance goes, but we'll keep going there. Another exciting product we brought forward just 2 months ago, last month even maybe, was our tilting blade scraper. So it's a much better fit for dealers and customers. It allows it to adapt on site. So there are just a myriad of adjustments that can be made to the scraper to adapt to each and every condition in any barn.
Thank you, Jeremy. And speaking of those scrapers, how can someone decide what scraper option is the best for their facility?
Sure. You know, one of the best things they can do is actually talk to dealers, and they can talk to, you know, other users to see what they've got out there. The big things we want to know is what are your alley types? You know, do you have rubber on the floor? Because that's going to change up how we're going to make it move. We want to know what your bedding type is to make sure that that scraper's lasting as long as it can for you. And then it gets down to a lot of user preference, a lot of different small adjustments that can be made depending on if you're scraping next to a feed alley, how often you bed, whether you're going to groove in there or even a deep groove so you can get that liquid away from the animals in the alley.
And talk to us about autonomous scrapers.
All right. So, you know, we brought this forward before. We've talked about it. We know the world of dairy farming is all about robotics right now. And robotics are an autonomous piece of equipment. The definition of autonomous is working without human interaction. So, you know, we've been doing that with our scraper systems for 30 plus years now. They work without human interaction. There's a little maintenance involved. They work every day, a number of times a day that you want them to work to keep those alleys as clean as possible. So while robots themselves are neat and cool and everybody's interested in them, keep in mind we've been doing it for a long time.
And so whether a dairy farmer is listening to this and they have a robotic barn or a conventional barn that they're dealing with, what are some general recommendations you have for manure handling?
You know, anytime it comes to handling your manure, you know it's the not pretty thing on the farm, if you will. So everybody wants to make sure that we keep it contained. There are tons of new legislation and regulations coming forward and all the different changes. The biggest thing I can say is talk to your manure expert, talk to your local dealer, talk to the people that you know that you can work with to make sure that your system is going to not only be efficient, It's going to work well for you. It's going to last a long time and be as compliant as you can with the industry.
Great. Thank you so much, Jeremy.
Thank you.
And we'll be moving on our virtual tour this morning. And we hope that you are enjoying this chance to get a sneak peek at the 2021 World Dairy Expo and this tour of the technologies and the experts right here in the GEA booth. And now we are going to be talking about CowScout with James Bringe. So James, tell us a little bit about yourself and what you'll be showing us this morning.
Sure. Good morning. My name is James Bringe. I'm with GEA Farm Technologies. I've been with the organization for quite a few years, but I work in the Midwest with capital equipment sales. And this morning, we're going to talk about CowScout a little bit.
Excellent. So to start off, tell us a little bit about what type of information CowScout tracks.
Sure. CowScout is a full herd management system that collects activity data, rumination data, eating time data, and really it collects all that information on our herd management software. It allows the herdsperson or the manager really get to the key issues that are happening on the dairy in an efficient manner.
Excellent. And there's a new feature, a new cow location feature.
Yep.
Tell us more about that.
Sure. So the newest feature we're incorporating into this tag is a location device. And the way that that works is these beacons right here are placed around the barn, and this tag can locate the cow within about 2 feet of where she actually is. So a key benefit of this type of technology is really to reduce labor in the facility, so an operator can go to a cow quickly, observe her, maybe even just for confirmation of some treatment that they give her that she's doing all right, locate her, take care of her, and then move on to the next animal in the barn.
So we're talking about finding cows within minutes with this technology.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, very efficiently, our operators can locate cows, handle them, and really not disrupt the rest of the herd as they're working through the issues that they're dealing with.
And when we talk about alerts, what type of alerts does CowScout send?
Sure. The system's customizable that the operator can receive alerts for any number of issues. So again, that can be a activity alert, for example, for heats if it needs to do some breeding. It can be inactivity type of alert. So if a cow's been laying down too much, really not getting up and eating. And again, that's helping look at metabolic issues. So the eating time and the rumination alerts also tie into that. So again, cows that are off feed, maybe not doing quite as well as they should be, that need some action or some attention.
And going off of that point, how does this help assist with herd management?
Sure. Again, finding key health indicators is probably its biggest attribute, but there's a huge component of these systems that really help reduce labor, and that's really one of the key issues that our dairymen struggle with today. Quality of help, maybe the amount of help they need. So it really makes them efficient as far as getting the right information, refining that information, and take actionable items that they need to do to be efficient and productive on the dairy.
Great. And how simple and easy is this to install?
Yeah, quite simple. A lot of this technology is wireless. So again, this tag feeds up into an antenna and collects that information. And that can be wireless all the way back to the herd management system, which ties into maybe the rest of the milking facility with milk weights and ID. So it's integrated quite easily. Our dealers are really trained up on installing these type of systems, so it doesn't take that long at all.
Excellent. Well, thank you for showing us these new features on CowScout, James. And now we are visiting with Mark Walker. Mark, tell us about yourself and what you'll be showing us today.
I am the business development manager for liners and supplies for GEA Farm Technologies.
Excellent. And what is new with the global GQ liner?
Well, the GQ liner is a liner that's been around for a number of years. What has happened over the last few years is we've undertaken an initiative to try and make as many of our liner products fit in one shell. And we've dubbed that shell the global shell. And that's the reason for the global liner. That's why the name came about.
And what makes these liners unique?
Well, overall milking performance. The GQ silicone liner was developed with optimal cow milking in mind. These liners are production performance type liner, and that's why they're here.
Excellent. So as far as the on-farm practicality, how can a dairyman evaluate liner performance?
Aligner performance is evaluated daily as cows are milked. Some dairymen look at different reports. They like to look at duration, flow rates, cow traffic, and those numbers actually tell them whether the product is working properly.
Excellent. And at what point might someone want to consider changing their liners?
Well, if they want to improve milking performance on the dairy, if the desire is to milk more cows faster, then they'll look at that. We like to look at this graphic here, which talks about optimal cow milking. And we try to balance all the factors that a cow has to see or a dairyman wants, fast milking, complete milk out, good teat condition, all has to balance on optimal cow milking.
All right. Thank you, Mark, and thank you for showing us that balance of optimal cow milking and the GEA, or the Global GQ liner.
Thank you.
And now we are at our last stop on the GEA virtual booth tour and back with Keith. And today, Keith is going to tell us about FutureCow. Keith, give us a little glimpse at the technology we're looking at.
So FutureCow has been outstanding technology. We've had it at GEA for a number of years now, and we actually now have over 350,000 cows out in the United States. We have grown. We can fit any size dairy. What we're showing here, we have our Elite 2 model that'll run two brush units in the parlor, and it has monitoring whether we're doing prep correctly. And what we're showing here is our Pro 3X. So Pro, we can actually do three brush units in the parlor at a time, and it actually doesn't stop there. Our control chart here shows that we can do a 6X farm, so we can do six brush units for a large parlor. The 3X we showed, a 2X for economy for a smaller parlor, or we can do our monitoring with the dual and single elite. And then we have our LT and our 2 AM for small farms.
Excellent. So Keith, why would someone consider adding FutureCow to their milking prep routine?
Well, I think I told you this earlier this morning, consistency. So we get consistency in stimulation, we get consistency in milk quality, and consistency in cleaning the teat. And like we talked about before, I mean, with the workforce, you know, we need people that are ready to go and easy to train, and the tools to do it, and this is one of them.
So. And it looks like this technology has become quite versatile. Are there certain types of barns and setups that it works best in?
You know, we've worked in all kinds of setups. You know, we've got tons of parallels. We got tons of herringbones, rotaries. We have stall barn cart units. One consideration you make when you go in a rotary is the speed, because you still only have so much time to do a job. So if your rotary's going like, you know, 4 seconds a cow, you might need more than one scrubber, or you might need some additional drying and other things like that. But basically, we can make it work for all barn types.
Excellent. So functionality is on point. Let's talk results. What type of results are dairies seeing when they implement a system like this?
Okay, you're implementing a new thing. So, you know, there's some training involved, and you're going to use some different muscles, especially in that first couple of weeks. But long-term results, we've seen dairies that have reduced somatic cell count. We've seen dairies that have increased milk flow. I mean, we've seen a lot of consistency in their results. I mean, there's times when dairies see their numbers go up and down like this. We're seeing more straight curves with this. And part of that success is also paired with our FutureCow prep solution. So part of this is it's got patented technology to use chlorine dioxide that dries quickly along with it. So we kill quickly, and it, you know, cleans quickly, and it dries quickly. So that's a big part of this, is paired with our chlorine dioxide solution.
Excellent. So it's a combination of the technology on the unit side, but then also the solution that runs through the FutureCow brush.
Absolutely. And we've gotten the patented antimicrobial brushes. We have a dual layer brush to be a teat end brush. And the model I'm showing here is the derriere. So what that means, after we scrub, we can basically, it'll have an air that'll dry the teats.
Excellent, excellent. And is there anything new that you are featuring here at World Dairy Expo from FutureCow?
That's the derriere. The new part is the Pro Series. So like I said, we have the Pro 6X, the Pro 3X, and the Pro 2X. So that is new, and it has been widely adopted. Even though we were not at World Dairy Expo, no one was last year. We've got an incredible amount of these systems out, and we've been selling most of them with derriere. So.
Excellent. Well, thank you, Keith, for showing us the greatest and latest from FutureCow and the greatest and latest from GEA Farm Technologies as we've walked through this virtual tour of the booth right here at the 2021 World Dairy Expo. So we thank you for joining us on this tour. We hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have any questions about the technologies you've seen or for these renowned experts in the field from GEA, go ahead and drop those in the chat below, and those will be answered this week here at World Dairy Expo and next week. So we thank you for joining us. And if you're in Madison this week, stop by the GEA Farm Technologies booth right here at World Dairy Expo. Thanks for joining us.